We know you're excited. You found an LMS that matches the user experience of Instagram, TikTok, Netflix, and you didn't have to code it yourself. Pretty cool. And it comes from the motherland, Greece. So today we are going to tell you how to get started with Talent Cards. We're gonna go through how to sign up for an account. Cool thing is you can actually sign up for a free account. And then we're gonna go through our 5-step checklist that you need to do with your new Talent Cards account to get a course created or a card set created and in front of your users as soon as possible. And the cool thing is you can actually get it in front of your learners without paying for it. So you can test it, get that feedback before you upgrade to the standard or the premium package. My name is Johnny Havey, and I'm one of the co-founders of eLearning Partners. And we created this channel so that you can just go out there and focus on providing amazing value to your learners and engage with our channel, and we'll simplify the rest. Let's dive in. Our 5-step checklist to getting started with Talent Cards. So, talentcards.com, here we go. We are on the pricing page. As you can see, there is monthly and yearly pricing. The cool thing is Talent Cards, to begin with, is a very affordable LMS. And you can start for free. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna click on the start for free icon. And this is our first step, is signing up for free. So what you can do is, let's add our name here. We'll put test account, company name, go test account. We will add our email here. And come up with a password. Accept terms, create. There we go. Welcome test. Before we get started, tell us about yourself. Click start. Who do you want to train with Talent Cards? Well, let's see. As we've said in prior videos, our choice LMS for mobile training for internal training, so your employees, team members, and contractors, is Talent Cards. Now, you can use Talent Cards to sell training to your customers. So you do have customers and some other options here too, but I'm gonna say that I wanna train remote employees, office employees, deskless employees, contractors. There we go, continue. Here we go, next. What type of training would you like to deliver? Onboarding, compliance, sales, technical, soft skills, product, customer service, reinforcement training, all these different options. I'm gonna pick sales and onboarding and soft skills. Go continue. How many people do you want to train? Let's see, 1 to 10, you do 10,000 plus. We're gonna say 200 to 500. One question to go. Here we go. What's the last question? Which industry does your company belong to? Let's see. We'll say, there's a bunch of options here. I'm going to say consulting. And then we get to enter Talent Cards. So they've collected some data from us. And now they're actually going to guide you how to start. So let us guide you. Follow along as we show you how to create a card set. So that brings us to our second step of our checklist, which is creating a card set. So let's click right here, guide me on how to create a card set. Now, when you're looking at building an online course, specifically with Talent Cards, card sets are your course. And then the cards are kind of your mini micro learning modules that make up your course. So here we go. Let's take a tour of the card editor. Let's go, adding a background. So you can add different backgrounds to your cards. Here we go, there. Then we can add text. We can add media. So it's really cool. You can build a micro learning video-based program by having videos live on cards, similar to a TikTok post. So when someone actually opens up the app on their phone, here, I'll open up the app right here. Talent Cards. There we go. Open up a card set. Here's a card set. See, it's just like a TikTok post. And then you can have double-sided cards or single-sided cards. Kind of up to you. You can have the video live on the front or the back. Here's the video. Boom, I open up the video. And there it is. Just plays mobily for me. Can turn it sideways, get a better view of it. So you can add media. You can either add links or you can embed media on cards. And then we can flip to the back. Like we said though, you can have a single-sided card set or a double-sided card set, depending on how you want to set things up. There we go. Another cool thing is you can actually set up QR codes to go to card sets, which is really good for on-the-go training. So here we go. We have a demo card set here. And this is what you're going to experience too when you first log into Talent Cards is they are going to guide you on how to create your first card set. We can add cards. So that's the next part here is how to add a card. So I just click on add a card and here it goes. We have a blank card. Like it took us through the tutorial. We can add a background. They actually have a bunch of backgrounds for you. So here's a bunch of templates. So we can pick one here. Let's do this one. We go insert template and it's going to add it to the card for us. Then we can add text. So they make it really simple. You can break it into three areas or you can do custom. And here it's not actually going to be in three areas. We like it broken down into the three sections. So we can just go test. Then we can add a bunch of content here. Etc. We go save, and that's the front of the card. Then we can go to the back of the card and do the same thing, and we can add media. So we actually add a video, and you can add videos either by uploading one, you can grab a Vimeo link, or you can actually grab a YouTube video. So let's grab a YouTube video from eLearning Partners, aka eLearning Simplified. Here we go, eLearning Simplified. There we go.
So you decided to guess.
And let's grab one of these. Boom. Paste the URL. Attach video. And now this video lives on the card. All you have to do is click on this icon and it will show up and play. Really cool how that works. So that's how simple it is to create a card set and create cards. Now what you're gonna wanna look at though, and we have another video on our channel all about building out mobile learning modules with talent cards, is there's different ways to break down a course. You could actually have a course broken down into milestones. We have videos on our channel talking about milestones, how to set that up. So let's say you have five milestones in your course. Well, what you might actually want to do is create a card set per milestone and then create a learning path where your learners have to go through each card set to complete your course. So different ways to do it. We really dig deep into that in another video on our channel all about building out a mobile module micro learning. So number three in our getting started tutorial, we go to users. So like we said, you can set up an account for free. That was number one. Then number two is creating those card sets. Well, now we want to test these card sets on your learners and you get four more users for free. You count as a user and now you can add four of your learners. So really simple to add users. Just click on users. Then we go to add user. Then we just put their name in. So this will be test two. They don't like numbers as names, evidently. So we'll go test with two T's. Last name, test with two T's. Add the email, country, mobile, add the user. Really simple. The second way to add users is to invite them. So you click on the invite user, drop their email in here, and this templated email that TalentCards has already created for you is going to be sent to them, and they'll be able to easily set up their account, download the app on their phone, and then they can start testing out your card sets. You can also import users. So from a CSV or an Excel file, just a spreadsheet file, different ways you can import them from other products, and you can import them from share servers, so an FTP server. So now that you have users in your platform, what you're gonna wanna do is you're going to want to decide what card sets they get access to. Really simple to do that. So you can give them access to one set, you can give them access to all of your sets, just different things that you can do. So I'm looking at me as a user right now. I can unassign, see, so I can unassign different sets and I can add different sets as well. So let's unassign, see, now I can assign this set. So really simply just go user by user. If you're importing in bulk, you can have a bulk action of assign all these card sets or unassign different card sets. So it's really simple. But now that you have people in your program, you want to view reports on how your users are interacting with your courses. So we go to reporting, and it's going to tell you an overview of how many users are in TalentCards right now, or how many learners, how many sets you have, how many completions that you have. Then keep going, engagement is going to tell you how many sets have been started by users, sets completed by users, users that have completed every set, invited users that have installed the app. And then it's also going to give you an estimate of the savings of commute hours, of training savings, and tell you how many better skilled people you have. So it collects all this data, has really cool algorithms to give you this readout. And you can actually download the reports with an infographic or a detailed report, which would be like an Excel or a CSV export. So that is the fourth thing that you need to know when getting started with TalentCards. Because now your learners are in TalentCards, you want data on how they're interacting with them. And number five, our last getting started tip on our checklist here is we're gonna go to the app control, and what you can do is you can actually do some custom branding. It's super simple to do and also super rudimentary. So really what you can do is add a logo, and we can change the colors of our primary and secondary colors within the app. So really basic, something that you don't necessarily need to do to start getting people in your TalentCards system, but something that can add a little extra branding appeal when people are actually taking your courses, or as TalentCards calls it, your card sets. So that's our getting started checklist. It's really simple. Once you sign up with that free account, you get access to all of this. So what we recommend is build out your card sets, test them on 4 learners, get some feedback, and then when you're ready to upgrade, all you have to do, click on the upgrade now, and it's gonna give you the option to pay for a yearly subscription, which you're gonna save 20%, or you can pay monthly, and really it's not that expensive. You are only gonna pay $50 a month for up to 50 users. And then they'll charge you per user on top of that. So pretty cool, really simple to use. So now you're probably asking yourself, I love TalentCards, but is it the right LMS for me, and more importantly, for my learners? Well, we have a simple answer for you. All you have to do is sign up for our free masterclass, linked in the description below this video. And in that masterclass, we go through how to guarantee the success of your e-learning program, which means that we are gonna help you define who your learners are and what they want, so that choosing the right LMS becomes simple. And then we're gonna give you a step-by-step process to take you from start to finish in building, launching, and getting sales, or getting employees and contractors, team members onboarded into your program. So check that out. That is our free masterclass. You will get instant access linked in the description below. Now, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, turn on that notification bell so that you get notified every time we release new content. We'll see you in the next video.